Barkati. So today I'm going to explain you guys about subject verb concord. So we are going to start with very basic things so that you can understand it clearly. So what do you mean by concord? In starting up, some of you might think that it's a very complex word and have a very complex meaning. But let me tell you, it's very easy. The concord means harmony or agreement. For example, harmony or agreement between group of people or community. And especially if you're talking about sentences, it means that the agreement between different parts of the sentences, especially subject and verb. Okay? Subject and verb. To understand it more clearly, let's take an example. Okay? That is, one dog is sitting on the grass. Here I am taking a singular noun to understand it. That is one dog. If there is a singular subject, okay, then we will take a singular verb. That is. And then we will take, taking a plural subject. That is two dogs. Two dogs are. Here I am using are means a plural verb. Because there is a plural subject, we need a plural verb. Like here it was a singular subject, so I took a singular verb. And then here is a plural subject, I am taking plural verb. These two dogs are sitting on the grass. Here I want to make you guys understand one more thing, that remember, always a subject. This subject and verb should agree with each other. Means subject and verb agree with each other. Your sentences, the words of your sentences should match with each other. Topic, subject, verb, concord, we have certain rule, and one rule is really important and a very basic thing you should understand before learning it further. That is, if the subject, if the subject is singular, then you have to take a verb. If the subject is singular, you have to take the verb also singular. Means, if the subject is singular, the verb must also be singular. The example here, the list of items is on the desk. The